Hey, Shalom, my Shalom. When it stops, those but give no praise to Yah Bashem, Yah Shah, Bashem, Makakadash. Double honest, supposed to JMS and honesty, brothers doing the work in truth, while sincerity. This one's quite hilarious because, I was with my cousin yesterday. I went to go see my niece and that. And basically just speaking about, you know, what I've learned working around, you know, white boys and that. And one of the things is how basically they talk about vasectomies like it's nothing, like basically getting their rod chopped off, man, getting their it's different, isn't it? You know, because these guys will talk about it like it's not something to be ashamed of, right? And lo and behold, I'm watching, you know, some TV and that some comedy, and it comes up again. So I thought, hey man, that's, you know, this was just yes, and I'm watching this today, you know, as a spirit. I'm just going to do a real quick one on it. As Deuteronomy 23 from the top says, he that is wounded in the stones, or hath his privy member cut off, shall not enter into the king or congregation of the Lord, man. Right? So you ain't supposed to be a castrati, for instance. Yeah, it was in ancient Rome. Yeah, there was them choir boys there, the castrati. Basically, they would get castrated when they were young, so that their voice never breaks and stuff. Man, that's off. You know, that is off, man. Right? But this is you know, and that's just the way Esau's fucked shit up. Because once again, Esau's whole thing is population control, man. You know, that's not a solution for anyone. Well, if your woman says, "Oh no, we don't want to have kids anymore," man, you gotta leave that. Obviously, you know, we're in this kingdom, man. We can't have joy of our children, you know, and it's hell. But man, children, you know, are a blessing of the Lord, right? Even in this kingdom, you get a woman pregnant. Ultimately, man, you gotta give praise to the Lord, right? The Lord is giving you seed, man. And yeah, in this kingdom, you know, it's a two-edged sword. You know, on one hand, you know, it's a blessing. On the other hand, it's a curse. Right? Because we always say in this kingdom, man, your children can grow up and just tell you, man, I want to be, you know, your son will be like, I want to be a woman. When you say anything about it, he's being sent off to live with a, you know, faggot couple, man. Right? But yeah, you know, those guys, that's not a worry for them. And the worst thing about it is, these are usually the guys that can afford to have multiple children, right? They'll be on some funny money jobs, you know, 150, 200k a year, right? But they'll only ever have two children, and that's it for them. Whereas, you know, Jake will be struggling on like 20k a year, 30k a year, 40k a year, right? You know, and that's two parents in that, right? And they'll still manage to have like 3, 4, 5, 6 kids, man. Right? But this is Psalms 127 and 3. Right? It says, Lord, children are an heritage of Yahweh, and the fruit of the womb is a reward. Right? And then here's the different thing. The different that thing with society. Because I remember my great aunt was telling a story about how she struggled to give her husband a child. And she was like, look, man, I'm of no use to you. Right, go get yourself another woman. And you know, it reminds you of the stories of you know, of old, where it was Rachel and who was it? Sarah, right? Rachel and Sarah basically were like, look, man, I can't give you children. Go, you know, get in onto my maid, man. Do what you gotta do, raise children for me. Right, through these women, right? Let me carry on. It says, as arrows are in the hand of a mighty man, so are children of the youth. Right, it says, happy is the man that hath his quiver full of them. They shall not be ashamed, but they shall speak with the enemies in the gate. Right, so having children, that's a blessing of the Lord. Right, and you know, so what if you carry on just having children, man? You ain't supposed to be getting yourself cut off, man. You ain't supposed to get your woman, you know, tied up either, man. You know, why go and do that then? Then what's her purpose for you, man? Right? But yeah, I just want to touch on that real quick. And yeah, I'm going to say Shalom.